Saving your Home Assistant backups on the Microsoft OneDrive in the cloud can save you from disaster. If your Home Assistant instance fails for any reason, you can download an encrypted backup from OneDrive and you can restore your system in a matter of minutes. On top of this, Home Assistant Microsoft OneDrive integration is super easy to implement, and once you set it up, you can forget about it. But there are some nuances and tips and tricks that I want you to have in mind. Please, let me explain. I open my Home Assistant environment, I'll press the C button on my keyboard, and I'll type integrations. Then I'll select navigate integrations. I'll add a new one and I'll search for Microsoft. I'll click on it, and because Microsoft is having a lot of integrations for Home Assistant, I should find here OneDrive, and I'll click on it. Then I'll have to open a website to link my Microsoft account. As a prerequisite for this to work, you need personal Microsoft OneDrive account. Work accounts and school accounts are not supported at the moment. I'll click on this open website. Here I will log in with my Microsoft username and password. Now, because I have two-form factor authentication, I should approve this login on my phone. I'll paste the code that I get from my device, and I'll tick this here so I'll not be asked again on this device. I'll click on verify, stay signed in, I'll click on yes here. I'll accept these permissions. Home Assistant will have access to my folder named Home Assistant and will be able to sign in to my account, but that's perfectly normal. I'll click on accept. And done. My Home Assistant and my Microsoft accounts are now linked. If I go back to my Home Assistant, I'll see this success window, and I'm now having a Microsoft OneDrive account in my Home Assistant. Before we continue further, I want to share that I made a PDF file that go with this video, and you can download it for free. You will get everything that is described here in this video, every link, every instruction, everything in one concise way. To download the PDF, open the link in the video description, follow this link or scan this QR code. Then you have to enter your name and your email address. You have to confirm your email so that I'll know you are not some kind of robot. I don't want robots in my mailing list. And the PDF will automatically download to your device. That way, you join my free PDF club. You automatically receive news, updates, articles, videos, and offers from me on a weekly basis. And it's a free service. If you don't like it, you can unsubscribe at any time with just one click. Now, let's continue further. I'll click on finish here, and if I scroll down, I can see somewhere here OneDrive. Here it is. This is my integration with bronze quality. That means the integration is having a medal, which is good. Now I'll click here somewhere again, and I'll press C button on my keyboard, and I'll type backups. I'll go to navigate backups. And because I already set up my automatic backups, I'm seeing this screen. If you see something different, you can follow this video where I'm describing everything about this backup menu. But it is pretty simple. You just have to set up automatic backups once, and you have to select backup locations. I'll scroll down to the very bottom and I'll click on configure backup settings. And here, as you can see, I already have this system, which means the backups are stored locally on my system. I have Google Drive enabled. If you want to enable this as well, follow this video. I'm explaining everything there. And now I have OneDrive integration, which is currently disabled. I just have to click here. And from this wheel button, settings wheel button, I can click on it. And I can turn off the encryption, but I don't want to do that. I want my backups on my OneDrive to be encrypted. And that's it, guys. From now on, my backups will be stored on my Google OneDrive. I can now wait for my automatic backup, or I can manually force it. I'll go back and I'll click on this backup now. Here, I can choose automatic backup or manual backup. Both options are fine. Automatic backup will reuse my configured options. Manual backup will ask me for everything. I'll click on manual backups, but automatic backup is also fine. If you click on it, no problem. I'll not change anything here. I'll click on next. I'll type a name here for my backup. And as you can see here, locations are selected all by default. And in brackets, I have a three number because I have three locations. Remember, local, Google Drive and Microsoft OneDrive. I can select custom, for example, and I can select only OneDrive. And I'll click create a backup. Meanwhile, I'll open my Microsoft OneDrive. And here in my files, under apps folder, I should find my Home Assistant folder. And if I click on it, I'll see my backup inside, encrypted and ready to be downloaded. This backup is ending with an ID. If I have multiple Home Assistant instances, all backups will be stored in the same Home Assistant folder, but they'll have different IDs, so no problem about that. Sometimes, instead of Home Assistant folder, a graph folder is automatically created, and that's because the Graph Microsoft API is used for this integration. And if you have here graph folder instead of Home Assistant, you can simply rename it and that will not break the integration. It will just work. Or you can leave it like that. It's not a problem. Now, if I go back to my backup menu in my Home Assistant, and if I select a manual backup because I created a manual backup, I'll see my test backup. And as a location, you can see that it is stored on this system and on OneDrive. If I click on it, I can download the encrypted file from here and it will be automatically decrypted for me because I'm downloading it from Home Assistant and not directly from my OneDrive where the backups are encrypted. Let me know in the comments, are you going to try this Home Assistant Microsoft OneDrive integration? And if you want to try the Google Drive integration, follow this video. I'm Kirill, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!